All right, folks, so I want to do a comparison video between two guitars I have. So recently I bought a Yamaha LL6. Now the LL6 is sort of like a modern day Yamaha. And this one is my old Yamaha, which is one of the old red label Yamahas made in the Nippon Gakki factory. Is that what it's called? I know that doesn't sound sexy, Nippon Gakki, but I think that's what it's called. It's like the Nippon Gakki factory, where it's kind of legendary for making these red label guitars in Japan. Let me see. So I've had this guitar for a long time. I bought it cheap. I bought it used, secondhand, for like, I don't know, $200 or $300, I think, something like that. Now the LL6, I bought it new. With tax, it was almost $800 Canadian. Now, the funny thing is, somehow I find myself always going back to my old red label one. I don't know why. And I wanted to do like a sound comparison of the two and see why I keep going back to the red label one. Is it because my ears are broken and I'm not hearing right? Maybe the LL6 sounds way better, or maybe sound is subjective and there is no winner. But to waste some time, I thought, let's make a YouTube video comparing the two and see how they sound when you watch them in the video. So again, this is an FG-180, a red label Yamaha FG-180 made in the famous Nippon Gakki factory. And that is an LL6 made in China. So I'm just going to compare back and forth. I might edit this just so it goes by faster when I switch guitars or not. I'll see. I might be too lazy to edit. I might edit. But we'll see how it goes. Okay, so, alright. Let me just start off with something really basic, a few open chords, and then I'll get to playing some random stuff. So. That was boring. Jesus Christ. I could barely even sit through that. I can't believe I'm gonna have to do that again now. Okay, so this is the LL6. Not made in the Nippon Gakki factory. I don't think the Nippon Gakki... The Nippon Gakki... I'm not sure if the Nippon Gakki factory still exists. It might not. Who really knows these days? Okay. Was something. Okay. So, last time I did, when I made a video on the LL6, I forgot what to play on it. so I might actually edit the video if I sit here and think for like 5 minutes going, what song should I play on it? Because that's just painful having this. Watch me sit there for 5 minutes thinking about what song to play. But for right now, I was thinking of doing some just generic power chord type stuff, because that gives you a good idea of the whole range. So let me just do like a... Thank you. Okay, that's the idea of that. All right. And then let's do something similar on this. Interesting. Very, very, very interesting. What to play? Oh God, I'm already oh Jesus Christ, what to play? 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 Okay, I'm gonna probably have to edit this part out. I might have to think about what to play. Okay, yeah, so I'm gonna do one more power chord song, and then maybe I'll do some riff type stuff. Yeah, so let's go with this one. Holy crap. My hands are getting a little too old to be playing this kind of stuff. To play again. Okay, so I thought maybe I'd do some hammer-ons, pull-offs, that kind of stuff, like in a Led Zeppelin kind of style. Zeppelin influenced style. I think that was pretty Led Zeppelin influenced. Okay, let's see how this one does with hammer-ons and pull-offs. I've tried recording this hammer-on thing 10 times, and every time I start doing it, The lawnmower outside keeps going on. Yep. Oh, it's off. There we go. Let me try that again. That's hammer-on type stuff in the style of Led Zeppelin. Okay, what else? How about some like octave type stuff? Okay, I have a perfect octave style song for it. I did power chord stuff. I guess I can try some like riff type stuff. Okay, well, let me try this one more time. The lawnmower went off outside. Drop D type stuff, riff influence drop D. Enough to give you an idea of what's going on. How much time is left? Oh shit, 2 minutes before the thing goes off on the camera. Let's just do this fast. Mm-hmm. my camera is going to stop, so I'm going to have to go on to the next step. Okay, so I had to restart the camera. It only goes up to 30 minutes. I thought I'd try maybe some folky kind of open chord type stuff in the style of John Lennon, I guess. Sounds like playing folky open chord type stuff. Let me see how this one sounds. Oh, it's still in drop D from when I did the riff stuff in drop D. So that was folky, open chord type stuff. Okay, you know what I'm going to do now? Hit pause, and then I might do some capo stuff to see what it sounds like on both. All right, I'll be back. Okay, well, I'm back. And now I'm going to do some folky stuff with the capo on the second fret. Just some open chord folk type stuff. Stuff on the second fret. This is definitely not a comparison thing that I'm going to probably do often. It's pretty goddamn exhausting doing this comparison between two guitars. Doing one guitar is actually pretty easy, but going back and forth is pretty tiresome. Thank you. open chords on a second fret. Again, I might have to do an edit because I'm going to have to sit here and think what else to play. Let me think. Okay, so I thought maybe I should do some finger picking style stuff. Even though I just cut my nails and I can't get the proper grip for finger picking, I can just play around and get an approximation. This is a song I wrote when I was 18. That's not true. I lied. I think I was 19 when I wrote that. Like, you can write a song like that when you're 18. That's ridiculous. So, this is the same song again. Listen, did I write that song? No, but neither did Led Zeppelin, right? So, I mean, anybody can claim that song at this point, you know what I mean? See, that's the irony of that song, right? That is the irony. Okay, I think we're near the end. So I did some riff-type stuff in drop D. Open chords, folky open chords. Even on the second fret, I did that. I did a little bit of finger-picking. I did a bit of power chord type stuff. I did octave, kind of like that kind of stuff. That's pretty much it, you know. I'm getting way too old. I don't have the energy to go on. I think I'm tired. I think I just literally tired myself out. So I'll leave it at that. I think that gives you enough of an idea of which guitar you'd prefer. So if you're out there and you're thinking, oh, I saw like a cheap secondhand guitar used online somewhere for like $200, and it's like an old Red Label guitar, now you know what they sound like. So now you know, do I want to buy a new Yamaha guitar or an old Yamaha guitar? That's the sound difference. Keep in mind, your guitars might vary. Your old Yamaha might not sound like mine, and so it really all depends. But that's what my guitar sounds like, my old one. I did do a few modifications on it. For example, this one has a bone nut and saddle that I did myself, so it doesn't have the plastic one that it came with. That might give you a general idea. And now I'm going to go take a nap. So thanks for watching and have a good day. Bye.